All right, let's get it going. I've been a Tool fan for many years, since I was a little boy, since I was a child. I have yet, however, to listen to Fear Inoculum, their latest album. It won a Grammy, I think. It was pretty good. Everyone says it was good. I remember my first Tool experience. I bought Undertow at an FYE when I was like 9 years old. Or my brother bought it for me or something. I listened to Undertow. I loved, all the other ones. A lot of good Tool songs. So, without further ado, first time I've never heard the song. I think I've heard it one time, but nothing like this. Not trying to actually understand it. Not actually lyrics. So, I'm going to give it an honest, unbiased go. First reaction video ever. So, let's see how it is. It's a long one, so I might not pause it, but I might pause it if I have to speak on it. So, we'll see. Right off the bat, this is Tool, obviously. They made their own genre of music. They're so groovy. Everything they do is just the epitome of high-level groove. First thought is, how much LSD did they take when making this one? Reminds me of a Tenchu game or something. Lateralis vibes. Like in the middle of coronavirus season, so those lyrics are kind of... Change up, classic Tool. already tell you, this song is going over my head. It will also go over many people's heads their first time listening. I mean, I feel like Maynard has always been, like, writing-wise, he's always been, like, how do I put it? Like, he writes not just about everyday things, but about humanity, the earth, and, like, people, and how people act when they're, you know, society and shit, and what's wrong with it, and how, and all kinds of other stuff like that. And, like, this is probably so deep, because they took so long to write this album. This is probably so deep you'd have to listen to it 100 times to fully understand what's going on, especially without doing any research or anything. So I feel like it's talking about leadership and, like, lies, and basically saying that the way we live as a humanity is okay, like, by government. Government saying that, and it's just not, but I don't know. You gotta be fucking high to get this stuff. My brother and my dad went to go see them recently, and they said it was an awesome show. And I've never been, but man, I wish I could. That classic off-time signature, that odd drum beat, makes you feel like you're off-time, but he's the one off-time. Awesome. Control. See, force it out control. Yeah. The government and what's wrong with today. Stop. Never-ending groove of this band is what, in my opinion, sets them apart from 99.999% of all other bands. That their music is made to not. It's just a rhythm to trance you, and nobody can do it like them. Do that specific talent, groovy, never-ending, incredibly odd instances of music over and over for 10 minutes straight. Nobody can do that. I wish Maynard would speak up a little bit. I kind of feel like there's no... His vocals aren't really doing anything for me right now, but... We'll be right back. Okay, build up, build up. Boom. Change after change after change after change after change. Oh, you can't even keep up. Okay, solo. Classic duel. Well, that was Tool, Fear Inoculum, the first song on the album. I'm going to do all the songs. I'm going to do all the whole album. Just because, you know, they deserve me to listen to them. I haven't listened to them in so long. I mean, I have thousands of Tool hours listened to, but yeah, I haven't heard this album yet, so I'm doing them an injustice by not having listened to it already. So I figured I would just get it done.